We took a flight to the Pacific Northwest. I've had a longing to go there, deep in my chest, like a dream. Left Portland in the morning, headed for the coast. Feels like middle of nowhere, winding down this road. And then I see it, this can't be real. Never seen a greener green than that. The sea salt air I'm breathing brings life back.
Dearly beloved, we have come together in the presence of God to witness and bless the joining together of this man and this woman in holy matrimony. The bond and covenant of marriage was established by God in creation, and our Lord Jesus Christ adorned this manner of life by his presence and first miracle at a wedding in Cana of Galilee. It signifies to us the mystery of the union between Christ and his church. And the Holy Scripture commends it to be honored among all people. The union of husband and wife and heart, body, and mind is intended by God for their mutual joy, for the help and comfort given one another in prosperity and adversity. And when it is God's will for the procreation of children and their nurture in the knowledge and love of the Lord. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes for which it was instituted by God. Into this union, Joshua and Grace now come to be joined. If any of you can show just cause why they may not lawfully be married, speak now or forever hold your peace. Josh and Grace, I charge you both here in the presence of God that if either of you know any reason why you may not be united in marriage lawfully and in accordance with God's word, you do now confess it. Grace, will you have this man to be your husband, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Joshua, will you have this woman to be your wife, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Will all of you in the congregation today, will all of you who are witnessing these promises, let go of your individual allegiances to each of them as individuals, and commit, therefore, to be committed to them as a couple from this point forward? If so, answer, we will.
We will.
Who presents this woman to be wed to this man?
Her mother and I do.
Okay, we have a wedding. Please be seated. Let us pray. O gracious and ever-living God, you have created us male and female in your image. Look mercifully upon this man and this woman who come together. And they come to you seeking your blessing. And assist them with your grace that with true fidelity and steadfast love they may honor and keep the promises and vows they make through Jesus Christ our Savior, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our first scripture reading today comes from the book of Genesis, chapter 1. We read there, "Then God said, 'Let us make mankind in our image, in our likeness, so that they may rule over the fish in the sea and the birds in the sky, over the livestock and all the wild animals, and over all the creatures that move along the ground.' So God created mankind in his own image. In the image of God, he created them, male and female. He created them. God blessed them and said to them, 'Be fruitful and multiply. Fill the earth and subdue it. Rule over the fish in the sea and the birds in the sky and over every living creature that moves on the ground.'" And in chapter 2, we continue. "The Lord God took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden to work it and take care of it. And the Lord God commanded the man, 'You are free to eat from any tree in the garden, but you must not eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. For when you eat from it, you will certainly die.' And the Lord said, 'It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a helper suitable for him.' Now the Lord had formed out of the ground all the wild animals and all the birds in the sky. He brought them to the man to see what he would name them. And whatever the man called each living creature, that was its name. So the man gave names to all the livestock, the birds in the sky, and all the wild animals. But for Adam, no suitable helper was found. So the Lord God caused the man to fall into a deep sleep. And while he was sleeping, he took the man's ribs and then closed up the place with flesh. Then the Lord God made a woman with the rib he had taken out of the man, and he brought her to the man. The man said, 'This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, and she was taken out of the man.' That is why a man leaves his father and his mother and is united to his wife, and they become one flesh." In Corinthians chapter 13, we read this: "If I speak in the tongues of men or angels, but do not have love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have faith that can move mountains, but I have not love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and give my body to the hardship, that I may boast but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. Love never fails. But where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when completeness comes, what is in part disappears." When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put away the ways of childhood. For now we see only reflection as if in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even now as I am fully known. And so now these three things remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Before we begin the wedding homily, I want to tell you how much I love you and how proud I am of both of you. And this little bit's for you too, okay? We'll get to the hard stuff later. Grace, I remember the first time you came to the Mission Chattanooga and you bounded over to me after the service and you said, "Hi, my name's Grace. I go to an Anglican church in Colorado." And I said, "Great." And from that moment on, my darling, you have been part of our spiritual family. I also remember you standing in my dining room on a spectacularly beautiful fall day and looking at me and saying, "I've been hanging out with this guy. His name is Josh, but you know, we're just friends." I looked at your face and you were glowing, and I knew this relationship would eventually be something else. Then you brought Josh to the Mission Chattanooga. And Josh, from that day forward, you became part of our spiritual family. I remember at Christmas break, you stopping by the church just to say goodbye, and me loading you up with coffee and goodies for your trip back to Philly. And honey, we have had so many incredible, long and thoughtful conversations about your gifts and your strengths and the right next steps. And you even called me to tell me that you were proposing to Grace. As I've reflected back over your relationship, my mind has turned to your willing hearts and hands, your posture of humility and your service. You've been faithfully volunteering for these several years with our middle school fellowship. And I'm happy to say you've shared your infectious love of Jesus Christ with our kids, including our own son, Eli. In many ways, these acts of service are sacramental. They are, as Chris said, visible signs of God's invisible grace. So right now, before we get started, I want to say thank you. And now for some instructions. In Hebrews chapter 12, we read, "Therefore, since we were surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us also lay aside every weight and sin which clings so closely, and let us run with endurance the race that was set before us. Looking to Jesus, the founder and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising shame, is seated at the right hand of the throne of God." Looking to Jesus, the founder and perfecter of our faith. I want you to take a moment and I want you to look at each other. Okay, now humor me and I want you to point where you're looking. That's a great shot. Did you notice that you're actually pointing in different directions? You want to do it again? Because that was really cute. Oh. Okay. Now take a look at the cross behind me. Point to the cross. And notice when you're both looking at the cross, you're both looking now in the same direction. Jesus is the founder and the perfecter of your faith, of your life, and now your marriage. In him and through him, you will have strength and unity. By keeping the Lord at the center of your marriage, he will continue to grow and bind you together. By looking towards God, you keep looking in the same direction. There's such a temptation to make your spouse into an idol. But when we look closely enough, we see the flaws. But when we look to Jesus, what we see is love. In the book of Romans, chapter 12, we read, "Love must be sincere. Hate what is evil. Cling to what is good. Be devoted to one another in love. Honor one another above yourselves." Love that is sincere doesn't look or act any way the way that Hollywood portrays it. Grace, Josh is not your Prince Charming. And Josh, Grace is not your princess in need of rescue. Leave these fairy tales behind. Real love is about choosing every single day to do the work of being sincere in your marriage to one another. It's not always easy. And just like dying to yourself every day for your faith, it's essential to labor and to strive to graft this marriage into something that is strong and healthy. A good marriage will make you almost unrecognizable from the single person that you are right now. In other words, marriage will and it should change you. And also, marriage is about discovery and recovery. It's a process. You discover broken parts and then recover God's true intentions for who He designed you both to be. The Apostle Paul says, cling to what is good. Ask yourself, how does that apply in our marriage? How do you cling to what is good? Cultivate trust, companionship, be vulnerable, set aside times for each other, create traditions and rituals, have a secret language, pray together, weep together, serve together, worship together, cling to what is good. Now in a moment you'll turn and you'll take your vows and pictures will continue to be taken for hours now. And it all might seem so incredibly overwhelming, but take a deep breath. Good. Deep breath. Good. And lock away these memories. Josh and Grace, there will be a time that you will need to remember this day, this celebration, this marriage covenant between the two of you and the Lord. Life will attempt to get in the way. It will limit communication and closeness. And at times you'll disagree and argue and pout. And you'll even want to withdraw. And you may be overwhelmed by named and unnamed doubts. Remember this day. Remember the vows that you're about to take. And remember this community who are surrounding you right now. And finally, don't be afraid to apologize. And don't be afraid to seek wise counsel, to discover what is broken, and to recover who God intends you both to ultimately become. Fix your eyes upon Jesus, the author and the perfecter of your marriage. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
Now turn to one another. Time for the vows. So Josh shall repeat after me. In the name of God.
In the name of God.
I, Joshua. Take you, Grace. To be my wife. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better or for worse. For richer or for poorer. In sickness or in health.
That.
To love and to cherish. Until we are parted by death. This is my solemn vow. And now, Grace. In the name of God.
I, Grace, take you, Joshua.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Bless, O Lord, these rings to be signs of the vows by which this man and this woman have bound themselves to each other through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So. One at a time. You go first. Grace, I give you this ring.
Grace, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And grace. Joshua, I give you this ring.
Joshua, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Now that Joshua and Grace have given themselves to each other by solemn vows and with the joining of hands and the giving and the receiving of rings, I pronounce that they are husband and wife. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. You may now kiss the bride.
And now we are bold to pray the words our Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, and thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray. Eternal God, creator and preserver of all life, author of salvation and giver of all grace, look with favor upon the world that you have made and for which your Son gave his life, and especially upon this man and this woman whom you make one flesh in holy matrimony. Give them wisdom and devotion in the ordering of their common life, that each may be to the other a strength in need, a counselor in perplexity, a comfort in sorrow, a champion in joy. Grant that their wills will be so knit together in your will and their spirits in your spirit, that they may grow in love and peace with you and one another all the days of their life. Give them grace when they hurt each other to recognize and acknowledge their fault and to seek each other's forgiveness and yours. Make their life together a sign of Christ's love to the sinful and broken world, that unity may overcome entanglement, forgiveness heal guilt, and joy conquer despair. Bestow on them, if this is your will, the gift and heritage of children, and the grace to bring them up to know you, to love you, and to serve you. Give them such fulfillment in their mutual affection that they may reach out in love and concern for others. Amen.
The families are going to come up now as we pray blessing over their lives, and there'll be special music. You're invited to sing along or meditate on the words of the song as we pray for them. Most gracious God, we give you thanks for your tender love in sending Jesus Christ to come among us to be born of a human mother and to make the way of the cross to be the way of life. We thank you also for consecrating the union of man and woman in his name. By the power of your Holy Spirit, pour out the abundance of your blessing upon this man and this woman. Defend them from every enemy. Lead them into all peace. Let their love for one another be a seal upon their hearts, a mantle about their shoulders, and a crown upon their foreheads. Bless them in their work, and in their companionship, in their sleeping, and in their waking, in their joys, and in their sorrows, in their life, and in their death. Finally, in your mercy, bring them to that table where your saints feast forever in your heavenly home, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with you in the Holy Spirit lives and reigns one God forever and ever. And Lord God, grant that by your Holy Spirit, Joshua and Grace, now joined in holy matrimony, may become one in heart and soul, live in fidelity and peace, and obtain those eternal joys prepared for all who love you, for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. It is now my distinct honor and privilege to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Joshua and Grace Van Meerbeke. May the Lord bless you, and may he keep you. May his face always shine upon you, and may he walk before you to show you the right road. Stand behind you to catch you every time you fall. Be beside you to be the friend that you've always longed for. Be above you to protect you at all times and in all places. And may he be right there within you, that you would know his love, and you would bring his love out to a lost and broken world. Go out now and serve our King. Amen and amen.
Yeah. Don't think that I'll be a saint. I'ma go down to the river. There's a way that the sky opens up when we touch it. It's making me say, but the way you hold me, hold me, hold me, hold me, hold me. Feels so holy, 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 holy. There's a way you hold me, hold me, hold me, hold me, hold me. Feel so holy. I don't do well with the drama. And no, I can't stand it being fake. No, 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 no. I don't believe in nirvana. But the way that we love in the night gave me life, baby, I can't explain it. The way you hold me, hold me, hold me, hold me, hold me. Feel so holy, 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 holy. Oh God, running to the altar like a track star. Can't wait another second. There's a way you hold me, hold me, hold me, hold me, hold me. Feel so holy. Say we're too youngin', the pimps and the players say don't go crushing. Wise men say fools rushing, but I don't know. They say we're too youngin', the pimps and the players say don't go crushing. Wise men say fools rushing, but I don't know. 'Cause the way you hold me, hold me, hold me, hold me, hold me. Feel so holy, 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 holy.
I just cried for like 40 minutes.
You did cry for-